This video is an overview of the features and function of Hakkotsu's Hades Arrow mortar system. If you're only interested in the firing portion of this demonstration, go ahead and click this annotation to skip ahead to that section of the video. On to the review. In the box, you get the launcher tube itself, which is aluminum with a plastic stand and end caps, with one shell packed inside of it and another separate in the box. The shells, or rockets as I will refer to them as, are entirely plastic except for the aluminum nose piece and the fill valve inside of it. The fins and springs come unattached, but assembly is very simple. The kit also includes an adapter to fill the rockets using a 12-gram CO2 cartridge, two soft nose cone covers, and extra rubber burst seals used to launch the rockets. I read online that 5 are supposed to be included with the set, but I only received 4 total, which is odd but not enough for me to request an exchange over. Then we have the springs and fins, 2 extras of each, and an instructional manual on how to use the system. The manual is actually well done, but I don't show it as it explains the same process as this video will outline. Installing the 4 fins on each rocket is pretty straightforward. First, slide the squared off end of the spring into this hole on the fin so that the coil sits over top of the peg. Be sure to install the spring on the correct side of the fin so that they will pop up correctly. The slots on the body of the shell are made from a very soft plastic, so bend them a bit to fit the fin in and click it into place. 3 more and the rocket is complete. The launcher comes with a foam block to protect the blade at the bottom of the tube, so remove that before you try to use it. The blade is extremely sharp, so make sure you're careful with it. Next, the rocket needs to be filled with water by unscrewing the bottom cap. The amount is up to the user, but recommended between 300 and 500 milliliters, or between 1 1/4 cups and 3 1/8 cups for the Imperial system. A quick observation. Although the exterior of the rocket is marked with the measurements, the body is completely opaque, so there's no way to actually use that scale to fill it. Then, install a rubber gasket into the end cap and tighten it back onto the rocket, ensuring that the connection is completely airtight. To use the CO2 fill adapter, simply unscrew the body and drop a 12-gram cartridge into the tube, then screw it back together quickly and with force. This rocket uses an entire cartridge worth of CO2 for a single launch, so stock up on the cartridges. To pressurize the rocket, place it vertically upright at your feet and place the brass nozzle against the fill valve. This takes an extreme amount of force, and I have to lean my body weight onto the fill adapter in order for it to start transferring gas. Worth noting is that the fill adapter uses a brass nozzle, which may be good as to not damage the brass fill valve pieces, but when so much force is required to open the connection, it was enough to actually bend the nozzle on mine, so take care when filling each time. Also worth noting, the gasket sometimes bulges out and extends past the end cap of the rocket precariously, and while I never experienced an unexpected rupture, to be safe, the user should be aware of and prepared for that possibility. Be very sure to remember to install the nose cap before launching the rocket, or you'll end up with a fill valve full of dirt as I did the first time I used it. Finally, onto the shooting. I fired it 4 times, using all of the gaskets supplied with my set. More are available online and will be required, as anyone picking one of these up will want to use it more than a few times. Use the minimum, 300 milliliters of water for this in the second firing. The rocket traveled 185 feet for this launch, a relatively consistent distance. This next launch used the maximum recommended fill of water, 500 milliliters, to see if there was a performance difference. This rocket traveled 335 feet, significantly farther than the previous less filled launches. Finally, I really wanted to try this, but look at it as a durability test of the rocket if you must have a practical reason for it. The rocket didn't travel very far, perhaps 50 feet because of the flat starting trajectory, and three of the four fins were torn off as it ran across the ground. A testament to the design and materials used, everything was completely unharmed, and after reinstalling the fins and springs, the rocket was as good as new. Overall, this set isn't perfect. The brass fill nozzle bending makes me question the adapter's longevity, and the nose O-rings leaked on my first rocket. I sealed over the O-rings with silicone and haven't had a problem since. But it would have been nice to have everything functioning properly out of the box. As far as actual use in airsoft or other simulation game, I can't say I'd recommend this. It seems very dangerous to me. When landing, it digs itself a few inches into the tough dirt of my yard, and I wouldn't like to see what would happen if one landed on a person. The practicality is also very questionable, as having expensive rockets and pieces don't lend to the part availability. The stand the mortar tube uses is also pathetic, and can barely stand up on its own, making it a requirement to at least manually hold it up while firing. Perhaps an experienced user could aim it to a degree, but other than flying straight, I didn't have much luck. Overall, it's an extremely cool set, but I'm not sure it would be of much actual use to anyone. If you see one on sale as I did, the purchase seems much more reasonable, but its use is pretty limited.